What's good, everybody? Welcome to Kicks USA, IG Live, Facebook Live. I'm hanging out with the Kicks Squad. We're going to talk about some of the hottest sneakers of 2016. Some shoes will be on the wall, some shoes won't. We're going to get into a nice little dialect conversation. We're going to have some fun. I'm going to go around the room and let everybody introduce themselves. We're about to get started. I want y'all feedback. We got people working the phones. So you're going to ask the questions on there, or you're going to give a little bit. You're going to just join with us, talk with us, share your input. Don't say nothing stupid. I come through the screen and punch in your nose. Let's get started. Ladies first.
I'm Millie. I have a nice little collection.
Hi, Millie. No, I'm just kidding. You got a nice little collection?
Yeah.
How long you been with the Kick Squad?
I've been here for a year, but then I was at UBIC for 5.
You was UBIC for 5 years?
Yeah.
You got a lot of shoes then.
Yeah.
I already know.
Definitely do.
Okay, let's go, young man.
My name is Bruce. I've been with Kicks for a little over a year now. Started up in the stores, working my way up into the home office. So here I am. I've been collecting shoes probably since high school, like my sophomore year.
How long is that? 2 years?
No. I can say that. My first pair of J's this week, I thought they was the hottest J's in the world, though. But it was my first pair, like, in sophomore. But that's okay, my little background right there.
That's what's up. And you, sir?
My name is Bam. I got an RA collection. Sold a lot, but...
You sold a lot?
Yeah.
So you sell sneakers? I'm about to kick you off this panel. That's okay. And y'all all know me. I go by the name of Mayor, aka 3000 Pair Stone, Kicks USA brand ambassador. And we're here to have some fun. So let's get right to it. All right, y'all. A lot of people do top 10 shoes, top this, top that shoe. I hate doing that because it's such a wide audience that we deal with when it comes to sneakers. Somebody loves Yeezys, somebody likes Jordans. People actually like Reeboks and Asics. It was quiet for a lot of those brands this year, as we all know. You had some drops though, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to my man Cam and the Fleabok. So you have a few things that hit, you know, you have brands that rocked a couple of years straight, like, you know, Asics had a great run, and, you know, of course you got your Jordans all the time, and Adidas made a hell of a run this year. So we're going to dip and dive, and we're going to talk about some things. And don't forget, I need you guys' feedback on here, because I can't do this by myself. Me and the squad, me and the Kick Squad can't do it by ourselves. So we're going to definitely need your input. Like I said, I'm not big on picking top 10s, but we're just going to have some fun and talk about a lot of the shoes this year. I will start with, I want to go back to the beginning of the year. So when you had the beginning of the year, you had your Just Dawn 2s. So the Just Dawn 2 was a dope shoe. Everybody went crazy. Like I said, everybody talks about Adidas this year, but there's so many Jordans on the wall. And you know, Jordan had a nice little shine this year, but it all kicked off with the Just Dawn 2 when everybody was going crazy for the beaches. How'd you feel about the Just Dawns?
I have a pair, personally. But I love them. When I can wear them, then I do. I try not, you can't overexert your pairs. You can't just wear them whenever, like, you see fit. So you really gotta make time to do it, take the right situations. But I love them. I love the quilted pattern on them, yeah. And I wear a 6, so I couldn't get the blue ones. So, okay, so I wound up getting these.
That's what's up. I mean, yeah. Why don't you like wearing, why do you just say you have to wear them for a special occasion? I'm one that...
You wear whatever you want.
I mean, yeah. Who cares?
I don't know. I feel like you can't just throw your heat out anytime you want just because. Yeah. That's just me personally. Yeah. But, you know, you situate it how you need to.
I get it. So, like, you know, shout to Just Dawn. You know, Dawn C did his thing on that. I mean, he catered to the women as well with that because, you know, that quilted pattern is like a Chanel pattern.
Exactly.
And that's where he got it from. Yep. You know what I mean? He got it from a Chanel bag pattern. And that's dope. So I know his lady like that. And I know a lot of ladies like it. And a lot of fellas like it too. So that was dope. What's crazy is I had to do some research, and I have a question for the guys out there. Maybe they can answer it. Does anybody know what the first NMD release of 2016 was? And if you guys want to chime in, and the people working the phones, if they want to let me know if anybody can answer that, because it bugged me out. Like, I was really, like, searching. Like, Adidas came out strong right away. You know, even with the Jordan play the whole year, Adidas did come out strong right away. And I don't know if anybody got any answers for that, but if they don't, then I'll be more than happy to share.
Somebody did say Nice Kicks.
That's it right there. Yeah. That's what's up. So the Nice Kicks, they were listening to me earlier when I was driving down to home. But the Nice Kicks NMD came out in February, and that was the first NMD release of the year. And there's a prime knit, and shout out to Matt Hatfield and everybody over there. I mean, Nice Kicks did their thing with that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, for a blog to get their own shoe, I think it was super dope, and they just executed it crazy. What do you think about it?
The Dawn series, man, I didn't get to get the first one myself. I love Royal Blue, so yeah. That Royal Blue kind of set it off. And then when I seen that he was adding a snapback to the whole pack, I was like, wow, that joint just blew me away. I didn't get a chance to get them, but that's definitely a dope sneaker. My favorite part was the color.
The color,
it's that neutral. You can wear it with whatever.
Yeah, the color's dope. And also, the tan, that whole, you know, the nude, the olives, it was definitely a vibe.
What do you think about the Nice Kicks NMD? Are you Adidas guy?
Yeah, I'm Adidas. I think Adidas came out really strong this year.
They came out crazy.
It looked like they was trying to do some punches at Jordan for a little bit, but.
I mean, I'm sure brands are feeling it. I mean, it's just, I'm sure on the whole everybody's
trying to compete this year.
You guys feel free to chime in whenever you want. It's just not me leading the discussion. Sure. I'm hanging out with y'all, so I want to talk with y'all. Y'all want to talk over me, it's fine. Just don't forget I'm the oldest person in the room, so I'm like, yeah. But what are your thoughts on the Just Dawn and the Nice Kicks or vice versa?
The Just Dawns I like a lot in this particular colorway. I didn't like the blue or the red too much. I thought they was...
You didn't like the blue and red?
Nah, I thought it was a little bit too gaudy. These ones look a little bit more premium.
I like gaudy.
And then like the gold accents on the lace tips, just like, I don't know, it just set the shoe off a little bit different. Like the Air Jordan 2 is such a hard shoe to like make look cool.
It is, but they
definitely.
You know, the last couple of twos, they did great with that. Quad 54 did good, look good. I mean, when you want to go back, to the Primo Ben 2, the Primo Ben 2 set it off.
Primo
2. Primo was crazy. I gave my pair away. I don't know why I gave my pair away. I gave it to my man Matthew Ragazzino. I don't know why I just gave away. But I got a hard time saying no sometimes. So, are you an Adidas guy as well?
Yeah, for sure. The Nice Kicks NMDs, like, they was just alright to me. Like, the tie-dye pattern is, like, okay. But I feel like there's been better colorways and collaborations with, like, the prominent upper.
Okay.
If you will.
So we're going to jump around.
Somebody did say they want to see the Hyper Adapts.
Okay, so, I mean...
I don't know if you want to save it, but...
I mean, if we jump, it's cool. Let's be working with everybody. Let's jump into the Hyper Adapt. You want to pass it to me, please?
Yeah,
thank you. So, shout out to Nike. I mean, Nike did their thing with this. The Hyper Adapt. Self-lacing shoe, the 1.0. I was lucky enough to get a pair or two. Don't tell nobody. But basically, I'm not going to do it right now. It's going to take me too long to take my shoes off. So, when you put them on your feet and your heels touch the ground, they lace up to your foot and they close up. It's kind of dope. And when you want to take them off,
crazy.
And they open up right there. So, you know, that's Nike's play on the self-lacing system.
So, that's so dope.
What bothers me is I wish the LA gear kid in me is gonna come out. I wish they stood lit up when you walk, but they don't. Eventually they turn off. And
I thought they, like, when you first turn them off, they would.
Nah, they don't stay on. Yeah. I mean, when you charge them, they got a charging system. See, they turn right off. So when you do that, it loses it for me. But I mean, it's kind of dope. I mean, it's definitely dope. The shoe is comfortable. Mm-hmm. I wore it to Art Basel in South Beach, and I had it on the whole day. I mean, I must have walked.
Are they heavy?
Six, seven miles. Not really. No, they're not heavy at all. Like, they're pretty dope. So I walked a lot that day and they were very comfortable.
Don't get no marks on.
I turned a lot of heads. Nah, it's all good. It's only sneakers, man. I wore, like I said, the minute I got them, I put them on my feet. So, yeah. I mean, no, what are your thoughts?
They're so nice.
On?
I haven't seen them in person.
You can see them in person. Don't dirty them. Don't get no nail polish on my shoes.
Nah, these are so dope, though. Like, I wish that they did stay lit up just because, like, that's also the kid in me as well. Like, I remember all my light up shoes, and that would have been so amazing if it did stay like that. But I just remember seeing, like, everybody try them on. It looked so super comfortable. I need a pair of my size, 5'6", just in case anybody got one.
The only reason why I thought they lit up, because the mags they dropped this year, they stood on all the time.
The price point on the shoe is a little crazy. It's $720.
You're
paying for technology, which I get it. I mean, it's just to the average, you know, I always think about the average consumer. I mean, I'm fortunate enough to get a lot of shoes, and I get seated in a lot of shoes. You know, I pay for these, just so y'all know. But I get seated in a lot of shoes, and, you know, I always look from a consumer standpoint, and $720 for the average Joe is just a lot of money. It's a lot of bread.
That's
a paycheck. So it's sometimes it's two paychecks.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Sometimes it's two paychecks. So but the Hyper Adapt is definitely a dope shoe. I like the way the shoe came out. We could jump all over the place.
Actually, I just had a quick question. Is that waterproof and all that? Is like a weather resistance and everything?
They told me don't Don't jump in the water with them. that's what I was told. Okay. And it comes with an 800 number in case something happens. So for 720, they are doing all kind of crazy.
Well, that's worth your money.
Exactly, right. That warranty.
So again, we're gonna jump back and forth. And like I said, it sucks that there's not a lot of other, you know, there's not a lot of other brands on here. But for me, like to me and to everybody on the panel, it was a quiet year for Reebok and ASICS and everybody else. And, you know, there were some things, though, that didn't hit. You know, like I said, I like, you know, shout out to my man Cam. Again, I can't, the flea box, I mean, what he did with those pink Reeboks was kind of cool.
Yeah.
But it just didn't warrant me moving anything else off of the stuff that I brought down. So we could have moved this Anis out of the way, but let's get on this right now. So I'm not. The shoe was kind of dope. I mean, I'm not going to lie. It's, you know, 11s are 11s. I mean, who doesn't love 11s? 11s are dope. It's just, I don't want to word this the wrong way. Like, it's missing something to me. It's just, again, it's a beautiful woman for, it's a beautiful shoe for a woman. And it's a woman's shoe, GS shoe, it's dope. But I just can't see the average, me personally, I can't see the average young boy riding a shoe.
Young boy, no, definitely. But that's how it's
right.
It's
but is it a unisex GS shoe? Is that what
I know men
to
who wanted
it.
I think it could be. Right,
I know. I've seen men in them already.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. And the crazy part is now they're going up to 9.5 in these shoes.
Yep.
Yeah. So I could actually get a pair of these right now.
Yeah.
I don't want a pair.
But you
could
if you wanted it.
I'll take the sole, I'll make it a 10.
We were talking about that earlier.
I guess it's the age difference.
So that's your favorite premium they dropped this year?
Yeah.
What about the fours, a couple of fours?
I mean, I like the, whatchamacallit, I like the cement fours. The cement fours were dope, all the pinnacle fours. Some of the pinnacle fours were dope too, but just
the Space
Jams. No, this one,
Space Jams are dope too. The Space Jams are dope. I'm not gonna sit here and say, there's something about the Space Jams. Like I said, we're jumping all over the place and we'll get to them eventually.
Yeah.
But I just wanted to touch on the Anis right now. And is anybody else saying anything about this lovely shoe? Are they calling me crazy?
I like it.
Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to tell me they're saying crazy things about me.
They're saying LOL. Right. They're not saying it's the 2016 bear. They're not talking about these 11s.
It's quiet for 11s.
They said those are better than Space Jam. I don't know if they're talking about the Airs or if they're talking about the
Well, we got to find out. Are they talking about the Pinnacles or are they talking about the Space Jam?
So, Joey Joe, what you talking about? Which one's better than the Space Jams?
Right. We need to know. Is it Space Jam or the Pinnacle? For me, it was the Pinnacle. But let's bounce. So, Human Race NMD.
Fire.
Love it.
Everybody went crazy for that shoe.
I gotta say, Friends and Family, my favorite.
Oh, Friends and Family.
Yeah.
But is it because it's Friends and Family or is it because it's a dope
colorway? I like the colorway and I like that it's not in English as well.
Yeah.
So that's what got me on it.
Okay.
They look dope. I see them multiple. I went to Comic Con, so I saw multiple person. They look
right.
Like,
they crazy.
They look amazing.
Nah, they crazy. They're definitely crazy.
I like the Human Race NMDs better than a lot of the collaborations because of the retooling of the shoe. It's kind of like a reinvention of that design.
Of the NMD. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like Pharrell kind of handled that like way crazy. Mm-hmm. And like that's what drew me to him. I was just like, yo, wow.
I will say, I haven't got a phone call from. I get phone calls for sneakers all the time. Obviously, everybody's gonna call me thinking that I'm just a plug because people think that I just snap my fingers and Kicks USA or Nike
understand.
Or Adidas just send shoes, and it doesn't work that way. Note to Kicks USA, y'all should send them, but it's okay. Nobody or a lot of the people on here would be mad if you send them. Everybody got love for me. It's no big deal. You know what I'm saying? So y'all can send them. It's okay. Y'all know my size. I have my address, obviously. So I never got so many phone calls from regular people and celebrities for a shoe more than I did for that NMD.
Yep.
I'm talking about every rapper that I know, every rapper's friend, every manager, every B-list or C-list actor or actress that I know. My phone rang off the hook for that shoe. And it's crazy, and I'm like, wow. And I did a lot of favors for a lot of people for that shoe. Like, I really went hard to give people them shoes. And my question to everybody was, why? Everybody just said the same thing. As you look at the way the shoe pops.
Mm-hmm.
Just look at the way the shoe pops. It's like it's a walking stunt mechanism. Like, it's just
I don't know if
it's a chick magnet, if the chicks like the shoes, or the guys gravitate to women more when they see the yellow on their feet. I really don't know, but I know the shoe was just a chick magnet in general, or vice versa. Like everybody, it was just a stunt 101, and that's what made the shoe what it is. And then for Pharrell to come back. With the colors.
Oh,
and then he dropped them all.
Yep.
And mayhem was caused. You know what I'm saying? Like mayhem was caused. Like I was stressing.
I'll
be the first one to say that it's a little easier for me than the average to get shoes, obviously. Mm-hmm. right? But I was making phone calls like, yo, I need them all. I didn't think I was gonna get them all. So I knew I had the black pin locked in. I knew I had the red locked in. One of my mans was like, yo, buy the jacket and I make sure you get the blue ones. So I really had to go the extra mile to get them, and I'm happy I did, because they all came out dope. There wasn't a whack. If you want to call that a pack, that was a pack.
Yeah, for sure.
Because there was nothing whack there.
For sure.
Everyone did.
There was nothing whack there.
Like, you may like one more than the other.
I think that's rare these days, too. Yeah. They have, like, consistent, crazy releases. Everyone. If you want to call it a pack, too.
Like, I like how everyone, like, almost had, like, a different...
They all get different.
They all had their own style.
To keep the same silhouette, change it up a little bit. Yeah. It's pretty dope.
Oh, I gotta say, Joey Joe said Pinnacles.
Alright, good.
I agree with that. Pinnacles are better than the Aeris. Just gotta say. He's hating on these shoes. Like, everybody wants to see the wings.
Nah, we rocking with you, Joey Joe. That's what's up.
The wings, yeah. Everybody's going crazy.
So everybody went crazy for the wings. You know, I'm not a big 12 guy. My two least favorite Jordans are 10s and 12s. Everybody tells me I'm crazy.
I can see the 10s.
A lot of people I know love 10s. What do you guys out there in IG and Facebook land think about my dislike of 10 and 12s? Who's rocking the Facebook Live? Anybody out there? Listen, young lady, you can talk now. I want to hear your voice. if they telling me we crazy, I want to know. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to know where I stand with my supporters.
Man, somebody said no to 10s. I don't know. I'm down with 10s. I like 10s.
See, I like, you know what I'm saying? So, like,
it depends. The colorway that
I love
you
the, so yeah, yeah. I love the
Dornbacher 10s that came out with the black and the red. I like those.
Cool. But the 10s of the shoe is all about the color.
It's about the color blocking.
10 screech crazy? Okay. I wouldn't know. Only got two pairs of 10s.
I mean, one's crease crazy, too. So you put a one on
the crease. But that's what makes a one to one.
A one to one.
Come here for it. Watch your mouth. So all you young guys, we gonna get into that.
See, I'm a young guy. I'm from New York.
We about to have a little great discussion. Let's go.
So I just want to know, like, am I bugging with the 20s, with the 10s, and the 12s? Now, I like 12s more than I like 10s.
Somebody said
10s
are whack.
10s are whack.
He said he rocks with the 12s, though.
All right, okay. I'm not saying, like, if I had to choose out of the two, obviously, it's 12s for me. Like, 10s are my least favorite Jordans.
Yo, Thad Greer, though, he said, so 15s over 10s and 12s?
I'm not a 15 guy either.
Okay.
I'm not a 15 guy either.
So are you going, like, between 1 and 14?
Nah, because I like...
Up to 23?
I like 17s, I like 20s. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's, you know, some... I mean, you could take 22s and throw them in the garbage. Yeah. But I mean, it's just.
I mean, listen. I like my 20s.
But that goes with all brands. I can give you 10 pair of Adidas right now at the top of my head. I can go in the garbage. I mean, like, it's just, it just doesn't work for me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? But so it's just.
17s I dropped this year too.
Are we missing the shoe up here that I wanted to talk about?
Which
one?
I didn't bring the King Push EQTs.
I didn't see.
No.
Have you seen
them?
No.
They must have fell out of the car.
Oh.
Oops. Don't kill me, Push. I'm sorry. Them shoes are dope, though. Like, the King Push EQT was crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to talk about that. But you got the wings. So, everybody went crazy for the wings. Again, Jordan comes back. Everybody goes crazy for the shoe. They drop it online. Heads go crazy for it. Everybody goes nuts for it. What was everybody's thought on it? The fact that it was crazy to cop or almost impossible to get?
Almost impossible. That's what I felt.
My thing was they looked like the playoffs with gold. Because I love 12s. And the playoffs is one of my favorite. That's an OG colorway. So when they added the gold, I said, man. And at first I didn't even know that little the wing pattern was on there.
Yeah, the concept.
Yeah, because it was kind of like I was seeing like little, you know, little.
So I messed mine up. Which is crazy.
Or did you?
Yeah, look. I was wiping it with the alcohol, and I hit the alcohol down here.
I didn't even see it.
Yeah, I hit the alcohol. I messed mine up. I didn't even get the wham, then I messed them up.
Oh, man.
What you going to do? No, my dumb ass did it to both shoes. So, you would think I would have learned on one, right? Now, when I realized it, I said, yo, let me go do the other one and mess them up. So they look the same. But that's just my stupidity, and it's okay to be I'm old, so it's okay to be stupid. It's all right. I get a pass. If one of y'all would have did it, it'd have been different.
Somebody said they can fix them.
My shoe fix them. You know what's funny? I'm one person that hates customizing.
Mm-hmm.
I hate custom shoes. I don't hate customizers in general because a lot of my friends are customizers. Like, Mosh is my friend.
Okay.
I talk to Mosh like once, twice a month, and we never talk about shoes. Right. We just took my stuff in general. But these are going straight to Miles' house to get fixed. Because he was my first phone call after I did it. And he was messing with me because I'm like, yo, what's up? He was like, oh, nah, you want to use a custom. You know what I'm saying? So he's like, nah, you want to be my man. So he definitely got me with that. So
and the gold on it just like hits.
Nah, it was a crazy concept. Yeah. I wish it was more accessible. Again, I want everybody to enjoy shoes the way I enjoy shoes. Mm-hmm. So like, I want everybody to cop their cement fours. And I want everybody to cop their first retros like I did when I was your age. Because it's important. I think it's important to culture. Mm-hmm. And I've always thought it's important to culture. And like, this sneaker stuff really means something, you know, on aspects. And another thing that we were talking about off camera that I want to bring on camera and share with you guys is that part of the discussion and part of the reasons that I don't pick top 10s and we're not going to do top 10s here is because I hate when people say a shoe was whack because it sat on a shelf. That really bothers me, right? It sat on the shelf, so that means it's not hot. You telling me that Cyber Monday 3s aren't hot? It's a dope black sneaker. It sat on shelves because nobody could resell it. So the next discussion we're gonna have maybe next month or the month after when Kicks USA brings me back, because they know how to use me, trust me. we're gonna talk about that. Is the sneakerhead dead? Is it a resale game only? So that's another conversation it was Space Jams on shelves the day after they came out. Yep. They didn't sell out completely. Did that mean the Space Jam was whack? I seen shoes. I mean, there was Bands, there was Breads, there was a few things available still. You know what I'm saying? So I wanted to touch on that. So just because a shoe is hot or not doesn't mean that. Just because it sat on the shelf doesn't mean that it's hot or not. And I just want all y'all to know that's watching live, the people working the phones are laughing. So somebody must be saying some funny stuff or they laughing at me. So I want to know what they said. What did they say? And be honest. This is a kid-friendly show, so.
They said, somebody asked where is this? And somebody else said Skechers USA.
Yeah. When we get a Kim Kardashian endorsement, she sit on the sofa with us or Joe Montana, then we can talk about Skechers. Until then, we ain't talking about Skechers. Skechers could kick rocks. Yeah. So we got that. I know everybody's looking around. Everybody caught the Supreme phase. So the Supremes, you know, what were you guys' thoughts about the Supremes? You've been quiet, young man. So
these the best ones.
This the best one.
I had the black ones.
Okay.
This is the best colorway. I just think the execution on the shoes is crazy. The red ones, they look like a puffy jacket to me.
They look like a product.
The black ones look like with the
red shoes. You said the red look like products?
They look like a product.
I ain't mad at that.
I think this is the best pair, by far. But,
Now I'm going to ask you why.
Why? I love the snake skin. I love the color of them.
Okay. So you're not.
And you I love the 3M too, because these joints light up when you.
Yeah, right, so you weren't a fan of the other three colorways, just this one?
Nah, really. Okay. I just didn't like the execution on it.
Okay.
So.
I'll be real, I don't even like that model. But
you like that model?
But that turns the
way that you construct the shoe.
Right.
That's how it makes it look a little different, look a little better.
So now, in my opinion, y'all touched on stuff. Supreme being the ultimate hype lord. In the world of fashion right now for the kids and for sneakerheads in general, everybody loves Supreme. Who doesn't love Supreme, right? I'm too old for this. If it ain't a box logo, I can't wear it because I'm too old for that stuff. But what Supreme showed you is they were able to take a nondescript silhouette and turn it into something and cause a frenzy for a nondescript silhouette. Right? We all know the Air Forces was hot when they did them. We all did it. The phones was hot when they did them. Mm-hmm. Well, you got to mumble when I say Air Forces. You know what I'm saying? I'm just messing with you. You just locked up and sat next to me, man. That's what it was.
Right.
You just locked up and sat next to me. But nah, they took a nondescript silhouette and turned it into something, right?
Definitely.
So shout out to Nike for, I don't know if Nike gave Supreme that or if Supreme asked for it. I haven't worked out, they took a nondescript silhouette and made it into something. So that's when you know that no matter what's happening in the world right now when it comes to fashion, Nike could turn nothing into something. And that's proof in the pudding, right? Along with the great Supreme collaboration, because everybody loves Supreme, right? So now again, is it an Adidas year? Is it a Jordan year?
Jeez.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't know. The grade school, they didn't do it justice.
Fans,
I agree.
Quality is amazing.
Men's left up this
year.
The shoe, I mean, the only other shoe I seen with this kind of quality was the Shatter Back
Boy. Exactly.
The first Shatter Back Boy.
I will say though, with the Shatter Back Boy, and they gave the Gray School the same love that they did with the Breads. The Breads and Gray School are the same, for me, quality as the ones from 13th.
So to me, these are crazy. These are so hot, and for Jordan to just come back and murder the game like they always do with something, right? And especially when everybody's having a rough year right now because of Adi, right? We're not hot enough, and you know, I talk to Nike people, I talk to Jordan people all day, mm-hmm. and they admit when they got a foot in their behind right now, you know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? And they come back and they launch things and they do things and they make things work. And when you have these conversations with these brands, and they understand that somebody else is crushing it, mm-hmm. you rest assured that they work to fix it. You know what I'm saying? So you never count these brands out, never. You know what I'm saying? Like Jordan is Mike Tyson. You know what I'm saying? You never count them out. You know what I'm saying? You never do nothing. Like, it's just, it is what it's gonna be. And Adidas is just having a heck of a run, and it's crazy, right? So you're mad because.
You mad because
you got little feet, right? You mad because mom and dad had little feet, right?
No.
So you mad because mom and dad had little feet, right?
Oh, you trying to call cool. my family?
I'm just saying, mom and dad, listen, it's all right.
It's all right.
They got little feet, right? So it's cool, right? We were all blessed and fortunate, right?
Yes,
so,
we were.
Anyway.
I mean, there's really nothing to say, but I mean, the shoe was just, it was a great release.
I had to get two.
These were around after release. It's not like they weren't around. They were around. And that's the dope part. I mean, that's the dope part is that everybody can experience it. It sucks. You guys work in retail. Some of you guys graduated from the retail to the offices now. I don't know if you guys don't remember because you're younger, but I was able to, as a kid, have a good report card to ask my mom, you know what I'm saying, or my grandfather to buy me a pair of Jordans. You know, there was a time and point where you could, if you had a good report card and you asked your mom and dad for a pair of Jordans or a pair of Ultra Boots now, you can't get them because they're not in stores.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So you had that phase and now it's come back where they're available, and I'm kind of glad it's available because I want every kid to have them.
So let me ask you this, when you think that phase went out the window where you were able to like walk in the store, because I remember, 2008, 2009, I was able to walk in the store and cop the spacing.
Yeah,
I was able to walk on the wall.
10, 11. Yeah. That's when everything changed.
Right, but you got to understand. So now, when you guys work with a store that's got a very big chain of stores, mm-hmm. numbers are numbers. Jordan Brand, Nike, Adidas, Reebok, they all got to answer to their stockholders. So they released 185,000 pair of shoes of a Space Jam in 2009, whatever year it came out. In 2010, the next Christmas shoe is going to be 220,000 mm-hmm. ounces. They got 220,000 pigs. They got to beat that number.
Yeah.
The next pair after that is going to be 270,000. Mm-hmm. Now it's going to get to a point where they're producing 500,000 pair of shoes. So they're going to sit on shelves eventually. Mm-hmm. But there's nothing wrong with that. That doesn't mean that the shoe is whack. Dude, that's the part that bothers me. Everything doesn't have to be an exclusive.
Mm-hmm.
Everything does not have to be an exclusive. And it sucks that there's nothing but exclusives on the wall. Because when you bring stuff to the people and you're dealing with the masses, and it's not nobody's fault, but everybody wants heat.
Mm-hmm.
But who's to say that regular inline Air Forces aren't dope? Who's to say that white on white Air Forces aren't still dope when they bring back a white and royal blue with the whole thing? Who's to say a regular pair of Stan Smiths ain't hot? Mm-hmm. How many shell toes y'all sell? Y'all still sell a lot of shell toes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Y'all still sell a lot of Stan Smiths.
Yep.
Y'all still sell Air Forces. I mean, shoes still sell. Like, they really still sell. And it's crazy. It just doesn't have to be a success for it to be that way. What are the people in La La Land saying?
They
want to
see the NMV.
Hey, yo, they
I want all of y'all to look at me. No. No. I'm not doing it. It's not happening. And Facebook Live is only 30 minutes, right? So I'm going to wait like 29 minutes. But I'm going to grab it in the 31st minute. So go log on to IG. They don't care about nothing else. I'm not showing the NMD. Everybody hate me. Back to this airness. All right, give me the NMD. Just because. No, put it back. Forget it. Nope.
Nah.
No, leave it there. That's right.
Press the.
Yes.
So again, with everything going on, Nike finds a way to crack the game with Acronym
yep.
and give you Acronym Prestos. I brought the third pair. I don't know where they at. Somebody lost them or left them in the car. So yeah, the bamboos, everything is crazy. So I had fun with these in Miami, along with the
colorway, like
with the adapts. Yeah. What were your thoughts on what they did here?
I loved it in general, and not because of the hype, but I love the way the acronym.
I know you keep asking me that.
But no, it's like, I like the way the acronym constructs their shoes as well. I'm all about construction and like how they like put the materials together, what materials they use. Yeah.
Their clothing is dope. It's super overpriced. And I see acronym rain jackets be like $2,000.
Yeah,
like,
it just looks amazing. Even the Air Force Ones they did, not this year, but
the zipper joints.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like the fact that they use zippers and incorporate it
into their shoes. You said the Air Force was fire? My man.
Yeah, you're
my man.
You got to
know
me.
Get to know me.
So I'm going to ask y'all out there, the acronym. If it wasn't an acronym, it's just a regular Presto. Yes or no? That's what I want to know from y'all. Facebook, IG. That's what I want
to
know.
Can you hold up the acronym? Blake wants to see which one the acronym is.
Tell Blake to get a job. They both acronyms, Blake. Blake, go to work and stop watching this on here. What's wrong with you? They both acronyms. It's a third pair too, but I don't know.
Kicks
USA lost them.
What's your favorite color?
I actually like the other one, the bamboo.
The bamboo.
Really?
Yeah, because I'm able to wear it with like. So this is a little too. This is a little too loud, right?
Okay.
So I'm an older ass. So I can still wear jorts. I can still wear jean shorts and get away with it. Because Pharrell said it's cool. So I can still do it. Pharrell told me it was cool, so I can still do it. Right. So white tee, white button down or something. You know, South Beach, some jorts. These is loud and screaming. These and the bamboo joints I could wear with cargos with some G-Stars or some regular, you know what I'm saying, some Kip cargos or something like that. I could rock out. So that's why I like them. Because I could still dabble in y'all world where I ain't wearing a drop crotch pant all the way down to my knee and so on and so forth. I could still hang with y'all on that. So I'm cool. Right? So now we're going to probably run to the most nondescript shoe in the last couple of years, which is my favorite sneakers ever, the Air Force One. Watch your mouth, young man. So,
if everybody
knows me as the Air Force One God. I got 3,000 plus pair of sneakers, almost 3,600 pair, at least 1,500 pair of Air Force Ones. So everybody knows when it comes to Air Forces, I'm the guy, right? No questions asked. I'll be the first one to tell you it was dead for a while. I mean, I practically held the shoe on my back for a couple of years and nothing. And then you get the young boys like my man John Geiger, he starts doing all kind of splashes with it and it comes back and I appreciated that and that was dope. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, when you pass the torch on to the young guys and they still give that shoe some life, it meant a lot to me. So we're gonna go with what Nike just came back with, a splash, and I know they smacked the world with this, because when I got the shoe, when Nike was bringing this out and it was coming out at 21 Mercer Nike Lab, and they were the first ones to get it, when it was coming out, I got a pair early. And I got a phone call from somebody at Nike Marketing. Now, I don't get those phone calls no more, because as cool as me and Nike are, I'm not the cool hip guy no more, so my phone don't ring like it used to. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm a sneaky guy, and I appreciate everybody, and I appreciate all my supporters. I hate to call them followers. I appreciate all of y'all on every platform. That's why I rock with y'all, and that's why I make myself so accessible. But to the big machine, I'm not that cool no more. So I don't get them calls like I used to. And that's dope. I'm cool with it, totally fine with it. It doesn't bother me at all. I got the phone call because I got these early. And I posted them. And they was like, yo, where'd you get them from? I'm like, mind your business, I ain't telling you. I'm from the Bronx, B. I'm not telling you where I got my shoes from. But they was insistent. And they like, no, we want to know because the traction was so crazy. We want to start selling you product again. That's dope, right? They was trying to bait me in. I'm still not telling you who gave me the shoe. So I wouldn't tell them. But lo and behold, the fact that I posted it and it got so much traction, Nike seeing that my rhythm was still hot and I'm getting shoes again. So I'm getting shoes again, you know what I'm saying? So they did me a favor, these guys. Right here. Shout out to my man Ben who designed these, but no, I mean, so they appeal to everything. So when I talk about sneakers in New York, I talk about Houston Street and below and Houston Street and above. Mm-hmm. Houston Street and above was still anybody that wear baggy pants and still fall off their butt a little bit and vice versa, and they still wear a little oversized shirt, and Houston Street is below is Kanye West and company. You know what I'm saying? So, which is nothing wrong with, pants get a little tighter. Pants rape your ankles, no offense. I got a little thing going on there. But you know, so it's different kind of markets. This shoe touched everybody. I seen them wearing them uptown. I seen them wearing them downtown where their pants was completely stuck inside the shoe, which is crazy. But it's dope and everybody all the masses got to enjoy it. So now we all have different styles. Got the young lady. I actually bought the lady ones in tan, in a size 10.
Yeah, that's the one I
10.
Got.
So I bought them because I thought that was the dopest colorway.
Yeah.
So right.
Yeah.
So now you got your hipster cool dudes, which is y'all, and you, can you appeal to the shoe?
I'll buy that shoe. I need that.
That's the reaction I want, bro. Like, so
I need like, that.
In his mind, he's like, yo, man, shut up so I can talk. So, go ahead. You know what I'm saying? Like, go ahead, young man. Please go ahead. Like, this is what I was looking for.
Like, I need that because, like,
it matches your jacket.
It matches my jacket. It's, olive is one of my favorite colors, and what is another one? I'm from New York myself. Yeah. Everybody know Butters is always going to be in.
Yeah,
that gun bottom. That thing just shut it off. And then, you know, cats uptown, they love the strap. Like right. You said, it appeals.
Nah,
they do the strap on them.
Nah, your facial expression was everything. I hope all of y'all caught that. Damn, man, I hope you got that. This facial expression, that's a meme. Just so y'all, that's what y'all call them memes, I'm old. That's a meme next week. That's a Kicks USA meme. Trust me, you know what I'm saying? That's definitely a meme. So, your thoughts, mister?
I'm still trying to get a pair of these. Like, they're crazy.
You?
9.5, 9.
Good. Yeah. Those ain't your
size. I feel like I can still get a pair. These are great. All right, just wear the one.
Yeah,
I'm good. I got them.
Now you get the boot. You good.
Back secure.
What are they saying out there? Still, I know that besides NMD, I don't want to hear NMD talk. I know they killed me for not showing the NMD yet.
Oh, where the bungee at, though? You know what I didn't like? I did not like that they didn't tell you the bungee came on the bag, then you have to take it off.
That
the
was
bag.
Dope.
I
That's
liked
cool.
it, but
That's
I didn't like that I can't wear my bag.
I'm not
going to
be mad about it.
I didn't
know
that at first. I'm going to
get
not
these
with
and
the
I'm going
to
just
be
like,
the
oh,
shoes swing on the bag.
These are crazy, though.
What are they saying out there?
Crazy.
When I seen the bungee,
I'm
like,
no. They just wanted
NMDs,
huh?
I've seen people bungee.
Yeah. No means no. Guys, girl, no means no.
They like my second pair of Air Forces all the time.
That's your second? What's your first Air Force one?
My first pair, just plain white Jordans. Final,
that's what's up. Clark Kent will love you. Clark Kent will love you. So we have the linen. Can I get the linen? Because I'm too old to reach. There you go. So. Nike, this is my favorite sneaker ever in life. Anybody who knows me know I'm an Air Force One guy. I love Air Force Ones. The Linen Atmosphere is my favorite Air Force One ever. In 2001, it came out in Japan only. It was limited pairs, and I went through hoops to get this shoe. I had about 13 linens in my life. No matter what they cost on the resale market, I bought them. It was $500-$600 at the time I bought them. Nike decides to bring them back out. 35th anniversary of the Air Force One is next year. Do your math, 1982, 2017, 35 years. Y'all went to school, right? Not y'all, no, y'all are smart. Y'all went to school, right? There you go. 35th anniversary of the Air Force One. They're gonna be bringing back some things. The quality on this is amazing. The color's off a smidge, but 15 years later, you're not gonna get the exact same color or nothing. 15 years later, quarter waters are 50 cents, right? Now, ladies, don't cost 10 cents no more. The Hershey's is $1.25, right? So
bag
it's crazy.
Bag of chips is $1.
Exactly. Yeah. Bag of chips is $1. There you go.
Like, right?
Big air.
Speaking of bag of chips, I had a bag of chips, salt and vinegar chips on my ride, and nobody got me salt and vinegar chips. That's all
right.
What's up, Ryan? You didn't ask for it. You didn't ask for it back.
I didn't text you salt and vinegar?
Nah.
Okay, I forgive you.
So, I got you next time.
There you go. So, what are your thoughts on this shoe?
I love the colorway.
You ever see this before? You ever see the old school ones in 2001?
Pictures,
and
like pictures though. Never
not in person.
I would kill them Jones in the summer though. Like I would not bring them Jones out to like 4th of July.
Okay.
Just be like,
ain't nothing wrong with that.
It's beautiful, man.
They crazy.
I can see myself wearing with all white, just that. All white.
You can get
a whole linen suit. You gonna wear a linen suit?
A linen suit with linen, right? Why not? Right?
You old head.
You can get away with that. I can't.
You old head.
I'm happy. I started chin up and started like.
That's some Big Daddy Kane slick Rick stuff right there. But it's all right.
Classic. It's such a classic shoe altogether.
Well, in 01, everybody used to tell me, yo, why do you like a lady shoe? That's what they used to tell me all the time. It's a women's shoe. And I don't know if you remember Fat Joe licking this on MTV. Shout out to Joe, but I every time I see that, I want to cringe. Right? That's my brother. Like Joe, I went to high school with Joe. Like me and Joe go back a long time. Like every time, I can't think of that. But this was the joint right here.
Somebody wanted to know comparing the quality to the originals.
Again, with it being 2016 and you're not being able to outsource all the old leather, they did a great job. On a 1 to 10, that color's a 9. Like it's almost there.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost there. Like the only thing is. to make this leather as soft as it is, it looks more like a tumbled leather, and the original linen is not tumbled, but it was so butter soft. But they did a great job. And they coming back with some crazy joints. I don't know if y'all saw the NYC ones, the black with the NYC on the side. That was from 01 or 03. I don't remember. Don't quote me. I think it was 03. But they brought that back. It looked amazing. Because like, I still have a pair of the original ones, and I got them the other day. I was like, wow, it's crazy. Like, it's super duper crazy the way it's going. But yeah, so the quality is close. I mean, you're not going to get everything. Everybody complains about the price of Space Jams and other shoes and remastered. Leather's not going to cost now what it cost back then. So you're going to pay for what you're going to pay, right? And then everybody's going to complain. Everybody finds something to complain about. So, you know what I mean? Where are we going now? No. Yeezys, of course, the Yeezy phase, the Yeezy craze, the Yeezy this, the Yeezy that. Chocolate 750.
Chocolate 750's old. I'm still salty about that.
I personally am not a fan of the 750, just because when I put it on, I feel like it's like a little bulky. But that colorway is my favorite out of all the colors.
So you don't like the 750 at all?
I don't like the model.
When you saw the first gray one, you didn't go crazy? Like, hey, you didn't jump through hoops and
no.
Everybody else?
Plus, they didn't come with the first one.
Your thoughts on the chocolate?
I need them.
Do you think this is the best one out of all of them? You think it's better than the original gray one?
I think it's better than the original gray one. Is a tie between the gray ones.
Anybody like the all black ones?
That was the first one.
So what I've learned what they've done over the number, I mean, was it four 750s? It's the gray, the black, the gum bottom, and then these, the chocolate. Right? So they become more comfortable over time. Because when I put on the black ones, when I put on the gray ones with the gum bottom, with the glow in the dark, whatever, I walked around a sneaker show, and I thought my foot was gonna fall off.
Oh my God.
I ain't gonna lie, I thought my foot was gonna fall off. So now the comfortability factor when you go from the 350 to the 750 is night and day, right? But I wanted to be cool, and I was at the sneaker show a week before they came out, and somebody from Adidas was nice enough to send me a pair. Yeah, Nike, Adidas sends me shoes.
Let him know. He sent them.
So I was able to get them early, and the fact that, you know, they were cool, but I didn't get a chance to rock these yet. But the gray ones, they hurt. I put these on and tried them on around the house because I got multiples, and it was comfortable.
You know, sunlight.
So now, I'm going to be honest now. So now we on the V2, right? And now they release all these colorways. Yeah. So now they call this Beluga, this whatever. But I don't know what Beluga is, but it just ain't whatever it is. Right? So this is the best one to me out of all of them. Out of the
100% right.
V2, yeah, right? Yeah. Am I right?
I agree.
So I have them all. Yeah. I was disappointed that the white ones aren't white, it's off-white.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I was real disappointed at that. But now, these shoes, you can't look in the store to get them, obviously. So they're never going to sit because of what it is and because of the Kanye West machine. But when you look at the resale spots, the numbers on these are cheap. Not on the numbers on the other ones. This number still holds.
Yeah, the other ones, they're down.
So now that's the only way we can gauge, and I hate reselling shoes, it drives me nuts, I can't stand it, right? So, but that's the only way we can gauge is the Yeezy still high, right? So, and I'm asking y'all out there in La La Land, is it still hot? In Kicks USA Land, is it still hot? Because you can grab them. Look, the cameraman's mad because he got the black and the olives on. So he's like, yeah, all right, man, Kid Rocks. You know what I'm saying? But
he got every pair.
So, got every pair. So, all right, I ain't mad at you. Of course you got every pair. You got six of every pair. I know. Kicks USA privileged children, see?
If only.
Right. So, I'm going, look, anybody in the background like, yeah, right, man, stop.
Not us, no.
Y'all about to hand out some pink slips in a minute. There's gonna be some terminations going on around here in a minute. The unemployment line about to be real. So that's the only way you can gauge is the Yeezy still calling for what's it calling? Was it that they dropped three at one time and another one right away?
I think that was hot that they did that.
All right, but is it? So now, again, if the shoe was dope. So now, the only way I feel I can gauge it is when the next colorway comes out.
I think mm-hmm. it's the colorway.
Like, if the next colorway comes mass hysteria, the fact that they gave you three straight black shoes.
Mm-hmm. It wasn't nothing crazy. Like, it
or four,
was
just actually.
They all look the same.
Yeah.
Like, if it was three different colorways.
What's your thoughts out there?
I don't want to
hear
NMD.
I don't want to hear NMD. So they all still hot?
Because they ain't get them.
I think these ones are better.
So yes, everybody thinks they are hot. Again, this is just my opinion.
Yeah.
I'm saying, like, I'm just looking at the numbers on the resale market, and I'm like, well, maybe they're not as hot as they were. And the fact that there's so many still available mm-hmm. in the stores,
yeah.
And the number's not that crazy, maybe they're not that hot. It's just me. It's my guesstimate.
Some people ask, do you guys think this Yeezy craze will die out?
No.
Nah.
Do I think the Yeezy craze will die out? No, because Kanye West is like this is a kid-friendly show, so I want to say the right thing. Kanye West is such a media-driven person that his genius will last forever. Mm-hmm. His creativity will last forever. But it's a shame that his crazy ways is what's going to survive. Mm-hmm. And the crazy ways about him is what's going to keep everybody socially attached and socially hyped to it, you know what I'm saying? Because the guy is a musical genius.
Yeah.
Like, he's a musical genius. I'm not a fan of the fashion. It's, was it three Yeezy seasons of the clothing? I might like one sweatshirt.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not a fan of none of that, right? So all that ranting and raving he did about fashion, and he struck out. You're not perfect, mm-hmm. right? But the craze was there, you know what I'm saying? So, and his genius is always gonna live, and the craze is still there, so. You know what I mean?
Like swirled on that.
Are we gonna make everybody suffer and take a break, or are we gonna go straight through?
Swirl.
We're gonna go straight through. They love y'all in Kicks USA, because I make y'all wait till tomorrow.
See, like with the black ones, they got the, like, the.
So where are we gonna go?
The color.
I know.
All right, so let's start running through these things, because we do want to get to all the top shoes. We want to get to everything. So, Mastermind NMDs.
Solid collab this year.
So Mastermind is like the go-to indoor beer. Like, to me, Mastermind's not even the new babe, it's the original of the original. Because Mastermind mm-hmm. been around forever.
Yep.
And they've been crushing it for years. Mm-hmm. And they actually got a babe clothing collab coming out tomorrow, if I'm not mistaken. But, I mean, this right here, like, another shoe I got crazy phone calls for. This NMD was crazy. The Mastermind, the resell on this was retarded. They were going for like $1,000.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're still going for that, but they were going for $1,000. Which was crazy.
That's massive.
It's right, and now my thing is, it's a dope NMD, right? Because mm-hmm. we got the silhouette, and we love the silhouettes. But is this? And I'm asking y'all out there before I ask my Kicks USA fan, is this just straight hype because it's Mastermind, or is this a dope shoe in general? That's what I want to know from you guys before I take it over here, ladies first.
I enjoy it. I told my step, like my assistant and everything, that I don't like black shoes, but I do like these, and I'm weird. Like, I like the. All about construction, the way that they make everything look a little different, like right here, these little hits, and even the hits of like the branding too. Maybe I'm just a sucker for the crossbones. Yes. That might be it.
Your thoughts?
What sold me is the 3M, man. Like, anything with 3M, it kind of gets me, honestly. Like, Metallic 5s, anything, Dornbecker 3s, anything you take a flash on and it pop off, I need them.
So I can give you a pair of Vans with 3M and I'm in there, go.
I'll make them look hot.
I'm sure you can pull it off. You young, fresh to death. We know that already. Social media land is failing you. You young, fresh to death. We got it. Girls is going to be DMing me for your number in a minute. It's cool. We got it. You know what I'm saying? My daughters probably think you're cute. It's all right. We got this. But what I'm saying is, would you just because it got 3M in them, is that the reason you like it? Because we know you can make it pop.
No, I just like the whole NMD, the silhouette. I'm a big silhouette shoe. Okay. Like, kind of guy, so, like,
right,
like,
so
there's
so
like some J's and other joints that I don't like because the way they look on my feet. Mm-hmm. But and I like, but one thing for me too is when that the Roach one came out, the fact that it's so comfortable and so flexible, like,
yeah, so you're a fan of No Man silhouette in general, you know what I'm saying?
A lot of people saying it's just hype.
Everybody
keeps saying it looks. Just like, you know, the
it looks
regular,
like exactly right. Right. So that's what I wanted to know from you guys. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I wanted to know. Adidas catches a wave with the Ultra Boost. I want you guys to listen to me clearly, everybody here, because everybody, we all saw this craze together, right? This is my take on the craze, and I want to know what you guys have to say about it later. Right? Kanye West announces he's going to sign with Adidas. They announce the money they're about to give him. They announce everything, right? Everybody's waiting for Yeezy. Kanye West pops up doing a show in an all-white Ultra Boost. does everybody think that's the Yeezy at first? Because the Ultra Boost went crazy right then and there. Kanye West, and I told Adidas, I sat with Adidas people and said, you guys got a genie in a bottle. Because if Kanye West doesn't wear that shoe, I don't think the Ultra Boost is what it is. That's just me in general. That's me in general out there in Kicks USA land and everybody. I think if Kanye is not on stage wearing them shoes mm-hmm. and they start reselling for $500, $600, $700, $800 right there on the spot, mm-hmm. I don't think this shoe ever becomes what it is. Now mind you, I jog in this. You all know I got my sexy on now. Y'all seen I lost all this weight over the years. I jog in these shoes. I do a lot of things in these shoes. The white on whites, I destroy them. Like, I do a lot of things in them. I love them. I don't think it would have became the animal that it was if it wasn't for Kanye.
Everybody's saying facts. They agree.
Anybody agrees with me?
Yeah,
oh, shit. I was about to curse. Oh, snap. People agree with me. That's a shocker in general right there. But I'm glad they agree with me. So now, they murder it out. Black boost, everything, crazy. You don't like all black
yeah,
shoes,
I like all
which is crazy.
I can't get down with it. Right. I can't get down. I just talked about this at lunch. Like, it's just, I don't know if it's too much black. I don't know.
Does Kicks USA pay you for your lunch hour?
You know what?
I'm putting John on the spot.
That
pisses
me off. It's
not. It's not for me. And plus, I also don't like the Ultra Boost model.
You don't like Ultra Boost?
No.
Wow. You might be one of the first people to ever tell me I like Ultra Boost.
Yeah, I don't.
That's I respect it. That's what's up.
I personally, I don't even have a pair.
Now I want to borrow your foot for a second. How much off is this? How much off of a silhouette is this?
No, it's similar. I don't know if it's like the. It's probably more comfortable. No, you're right. I mean, it's a similar model, but it doesn't look the same either. But it's also all black. I don't know.
Okay.
I looked at the cream ones. Those were like probably the one color that
the cream is crazy.
Yeah, no, the cream is very
good. Anybody out there got a kit pair of creams or not? I'll take them.
Yeah, no.
I can get you a raise. I got the power to get you a raise in here, bro. I got the power to make a conversation and get you a raise in here. My name ring bells in this building.
Like
I am so getting fired as a brand ambassador after the show. I will not be back for the debate about resellers and sneakerheads because I might not have a job no more. So it was fun while it lasted. Thank you for the year.
Billy says someone said you're tripping.
I can't get down with it.
Yo, somebody, please pick on her because y'all pick on me every day. On all my social
that's
media platforms,
personal.
Y'all destroy me, so please get her.
Like, my favorite first Ultra Boost is the Jordan that just dropped, the naked ones. I said, I messaged him, I'm like, you be getting these? I wasn't a fan of the Ultra Boost until I seen the naked ones.
Naked is crazy.
Yeah,
naked is dope.
I mean, it's a polarizing design. It's like you like it or you don't. I mean, I like the color boost on the black ones. That's the first time we've really seen it.
Right.
I mean, they're comfortable.
Nah, they dope. Like, you know, it's funny. I can't rock with all of the uncaged ones. Some of the uncaged ones.
You know
what
it is? Mm-hmm. It's the collar. I like the old collar. I don't like the uncaged one.
Okay.
Because it looks like it's weird.
Right.
It's a whole shoe.
I feel like when you murder out a shoe, all black, all black everything is just. Like, she don't like black shoes, but I feel like when you go all black, it's.
Yeah, I have one all black.
It's strange.
You're wearing a onesie, though. I know.
What you mean? All black.
The opinions on the show are not by Mayor at all. They're not endorsed by Mayor at all. You understand?
Millie, they said how you don't like the Ultra Boost, but you wear the Turtle Doves.
Because I don't.
Welcome to my world, young lady. I've been getting this for like 5-6 years. Welcome to my world.
I
get the most hate on the net than anybody in the world.
It's
you want to pass me the space? You want to pass me the space jam? Pass me the space jam. Pass me the space jam.
Everybody
going to
humiliate
you. How y'all know my name? I just say my name.
So again, we go back to the Adidas craze. Did Jordan really have that bad of a year? Jordan have a good year?
He had a good year. Cause
right?
Great.
Like,
OG.
Jordan had a good year. So you got the four, right? Which is crazy just in itself. And this is probably about my seventh pair. Because I went crazy for these. I ain't going to lie. You guys are gonna stop chuckling in the background. What are they saying?
If you can't
read it on the air, bring me the phone. I want to see.
They're trolling Billy.
Get her, y'all. Get her.
How am I happy because I don't like Ultra Boost?
That's right. Get her. Yo, give him your Instagram. Get up, please.
They're gonna put sour bees on me in there.
They're gonna get you. They're gonna put lemonades on there. They're gonna put bees. So, did Jordan really have a bad year? Did they have a good year? See, I think they had a really good year because they appealed to my demographic, and they appeal to my audience, and they appeal to the stuff that I like. So when you retro these and you bring them out, the fours is crazy, right? Like, the Space Jams is real, man. Like, they even took it back to like the original purple colorway in the back. Like, the purple colorway is crazy. The only complaint that I never complain about shoes, people always say, oh, for the price, the quality. The only thing that bugged me about this shoe is that you can see the white line.
Yeah.
It's too much work. That's for y'all fresh guys. So you gonna take a Sharpie and just go like that?
No, not a Sharpie. I'm gonna get a fabric pen.
Oh, Sharpie, so you fly. You see, you one of those. So he's a fashionista. Are you a graphic artist?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what's up. So I want you to put my face right there.
Oh, I got you. I'll get you a nice little printout right there.
You gotta make my stomach a little bit bigger. Not like the pun logo, but a little bit in between.
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? So nah, but I mean, so like. I think they did it. What do you guys think about what Jordan Brand did this year? Like, do you think like Jordan Brand had a hit this year? You think they didn't have a hit this year?
People saying they did pretty good this year.
And Jordan ripped my pocket this year, man.
Right, Jordan always. Now see, I agree with that. But this was such an Adidas year that you have to ask the question.
Yeah.
And for people to say that and agree with it, I respect it. I could tell by everybody's looking.
I'm not even about to answer no questions.
Right.
I'm not answering no more questions.
Somebody said she's so bad. I see her kicks all the time.
All right, so
somebody asked if Mayer thinks the retro days are limited for classic jeans.
I don't think they're limited. I don't think they're limited because there's a new sneakerhead born every day. Mm-hmm. Right? There's a new sneakerhead born every day. And there's always a person that missed out. So I like when they make a lot of bids. Like, I want to see them make another Cement 3 again or another Cement 4. I love that they brought back my favorite Jordan. Like, you know, they retro the 9 that just came out. Why they call it the Space Jam 9 is beyond me. I don't even want to get into that. But that's my favorite Jordan ever.
I didn't even remember they having the glitter on it.
Right. So, you know what I'm saying? So, like, that's my favorite Jordan ever. Jordan 9 is my favorite, which is weird. Like, because everybody would think that since I've been around these sneakers and, you know, 4s, 11s, 1s would be my favorite. Jordan 9s are my favorite because I'm a baseball fan. Baseball is my favorite sport. And Jordan walked away from the game when the 9 came out. And he didn't play in the 9. And that's my reason for loving the 9 so much. So we're going to put these back over there. And now we're going to grab everybody's favorite shoe. And we're going to grab the one on the bottom, which is my favorite shoe of the year. And we're going
to
talk about
it. These are so light to me. Like, so I don't understand their deal.
Okay, wait.
You can't
see
those.
Same shoe? Okay.
All right, we're going to get there first. So now, of course, we got to save it for last. We got to make them wait so they can all curse me out. just remember, when y'all want to curse me out, just look to my right and just holler at me. You know what I'm saying? So don't
curse me out.
I understand I'm making y'all suffer, but I'm giving y'all fun here. We're going to throw darts at Millie.
Throw me out.
We're going to put Millie on black.
Shame me to the wolves.
Okay, so now, with the Ultra Boost being what it was, and like I said, I thought they got a genie in a bottle with it. Here comes Reigning Champs. Mm-hmm. Reigning Champs as a collab with Ultra Boost. And this is my favorite Ultra Boost ever. Call it an Oreo colorway, whatever you want to call it. The way they blended this fabric right here is nothing short of amazing to me.
No, it's great material.
To me, the Reigning Champ is my favorite Adidas this year. I don't know what your thoughts are.
That's a statement right there.
It's a little 3M hit right there just for you. So that's 3M right there, just so you know. So you might agree with me, that's 3M right there. But this is my favorite Adidas this year. That's just me. What are your thoughts on it?
I mean, no, this is
so
really
this is black and white. So how do you
it
feel about
it? It is black and white. Like I said, I wear black and white shoes.
And it resembles your dove a little bit as well. Everything resembles your dove.
It gotta resemble the dove.
I like the materials of it, and I do like all of this right here. I personally wouldn't wear it, but it's an interesting.
You know, if your parents have bigger feet, you have a matching outfit right now.
Yo, all these shots. Billy under rapid fire. I'm gonna let you go.
I wasn't really feeling these.
I want to know what y'all think out there. Why you?
I don't know why, but I just can't.
Right, so you'll pick the naked over that, and the naked is dope.
Yeah.
Right.
That's you why. Know, you know why I like the naked though? Because of the material.
That's why
I like the naked.
I'm so mad I didn't pack it.
And the Tiffany blue. That's one of my favorite colors. That Tiffany blue is crazy. But
when does the naked come out? Today or tomorrow?
They came out
tomorrow, right? Tomorrow. That's why I didn't bring it. I didn't want to get in trouble.
I'll
Obviously.
No more
seeds. I'm not supposed to have it. But I posted it.
Right. Not because the color is hot. You know what I mean? I like the color and everything, but Brandon Champ, you know, they.
Brandon Champ.
You know what I mean? But other than that, I.
So you know, you ain't digging it. That's cool. Yeah, it's cool.
It's a nice shoe, but it's not you shoes gonna blow me away. Ain't knocking me out the water.
I mean, I love the way they constructed the fabric and all, but these are light. They're light to me.
So someone said there's nothing to the Babe NMDs except the camo, but the Ultras are fire.
The Ultras are fire.
I halfway agree with
that. And that's why the Babe NMDs is hot, because of the camo.
It's just the camo. It's a horrible material. Yeah. Horrible material. It's definitely all hype.
I've seen like custom ones that's on Prime that I feel like.
Oh my better. God, yeah.
All right, y'all. Who got the camera?
They want the story.
Matter of fact, we're gonna dress them up. Hold on, shit.
They want the story.
Hey,
oh,
uh-huh. Chuck. Hey, cooler right now. Alright, so now, the biggest hype in America, Dape in general, which makes great product, you got the Bape NMD. Everybody went crazy for it. You got the black. It's slow. Oh shit. That's what's up. I'm about to start dancing, Jay. So there it goes. This is everybody's shoe. Everybody loves it. I know y'all love it. Here y'all go. It's right here in front of y'all. Look. Smell it. Look. Smell like Swiss cheese. There you go. That's it. There you go right here. I mean, you tell me your thoughts. I'm going to work the room. We're going to figure this out. Alright, so here you go, young lady. What do you think?
Not a fan. I like the camo, it's the materials. The black ones even, I'm even less impressed. But this is it's just all hype, honestly, for me.
It's all hype,
yeah.
Okay.
And I'm out with this right now. Man, it's hype, what? Man, first of all, babe is bait.
But we already know that young, fresh to death here, we already know what it is.
Babe is bait, man, but. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like the NMD, everybody know what the NMD is here for, but when they added, what side me is the bait, man? I ain't gonna hold you. Like,
that's so good. So I got a few things to say, but I'm gonna work the room first.
I'm with Millie.
I love camo. It's camo cool.
You wear Bape in general?
I love Bape. I just feel like they could have executed it a little bit better. Okay. Like,
I see customs
that are better.
I don't know what y'all think. I hate customs, but I don't know what y'all think. My gripe with the shoe is, if you gonna go hard and go Bape, why not give it a Prime Day?
Why not
give it a Prime Day? I think Adidas dropped it. The shoe is dope. Everybody loves it. Obviously, the resale market is calling for what it's calling for. Which is, I hate using the resale market to judge shoes. I hate that. But I gotta do it to appeal to everybody, right? I should hit myself with this one, right? More money. So, why not make it a Prime Day? Like, that's a question that I need to have when I say Adidas again.
I got a reason because of the jacket, the coat.
Right.
That's why I didn't come to Prime Day because it was the pants, you had the jacket.
Were we in the army? Your uniform got to match like that?
Nah, you don't got. I wouldn't wear the whole. Yeah, I'd wear the jacket in that, but the jacket is kind of like right, that material.
Like, when I wear my NMD Adidas jacket, I wear Tim's. Right. I can't wear the NMD. You just look like you tried too hard.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like you tried. Like you really stood in the mirror. It don't work. So there you have it, y'all. This is it. Nah, I ain't gonna do it. Here goes some of the hottest shoes that we saw this year. Again, we went all the way back from the beginning of the year to now. I hope you guys liked it. Hit up Kicks USA. You can hit me up on my social media, _Mayor_ on Instagram. My Snapchat is IamMayor. Periscope is _Mayor_. Hit me up, let me know what you thought. Let me know if you want to see this again. Let Kicks USA know if you want to see this again. We'll try to do this on a regular basis. We'll try to bring other people in to discuss shoes. We'll try to bring in regular consumers. Maybe you back there sitting in the house right now in your underwear watching me, which is not a good look. You guys at home, put your clothes on. Honestly, I think this was dope. Shout out to Kicks USA for making it happen. I think we could do this more often. Now we could take these social media platforms and go live with them. I think it's amazing. Let's utilize them, let's keep doing it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to hit me up, _Mayor_. Let me know. I want to thank the staff. thank you guys. You guys are the best. Thank you for putting up with my pain in the ass. We love you, Lily. You good. You know what I'm saying? Even though your turtle doves look just like, yeah, we good. It's all right. We gonna live. It's all good. Your parents should have had bigger feet. All right, y'all. We out. Salute.